Hello, this is Haley McLaughlin with the League of Women Voters of Portland, and you are watching the Video Voters Guide. We, in conjunction with Metro East Community Media, are here to talk with candidates running in the May 2020 primary election. With me today is Michael O'Callaghan, running for Mayor, City of Portland. Welcome, Michael.
Thank you. Appreciate the opportunity.
Absolutely. All right. Please tell us a little bit about yourself and why you're running for office and what unique characteristics you have among all the candidates for this office.
Okay, a little bit about myself. I was born in Portland and I went to Alaska for 35 years and did a lot of activities up there. I started a free food program with my bike and trailer, and we gave away about 17 million pounds of food with that. Started a fish giveaway for 5 years. We gave away 2.5 million pounds of fish and 120,000 pounds here in Portland. And I got a whole list of brags that we can use. But anyway, that's a little bit about myself. And one of the things I noticed when I made up my list of 18 brags is that there was a commonality in it. And the commonality is that I like organizing to benefit everybody. And my past record shows that, there's no doubt about that. And we're certainly in a very unique time now. And what the future holds, we really don't know, but it could be time for opportunity, could be time for disaster. But so that's one of the reasons why I'm running for office, is because I think I can make a difference. But one of the more important things about the campaign is that we want some bottom-up input. We have enough top-down, a hard time to get bottom-up input. So in our campaign, we have four housing ideas. We have four clean air ideas, a government idea. And so we are asking people if they will weigh in on this and whatever ideas, being an activist, I look for a 70-30 split. Yay, nay. And that's pretty easy to get it done. So that's what we do. And we have three issues, which they're 100%ers, okay? And one, which should be enacted right now, is that France and Italy made it illegal to throw away dated food. We could feed thousands of people right now. There's a food shortage. City Council could do this. I talked to them about it on Wednesday. We'll see if that happens. And so that's a little bit about me. So,
great. Thank you. With the COVID-19 pandemic and the resulting devastation of small business, city employee layoffs, and housing displacement will be with us for some time. How would you seek to address the fallout, including the reduction in city revenue?
Well, dealing with the COVID thing, the basic thing is that nobody has work. Okay, if nobody has work, they can't pay the rent. Wall Street Journal, 30% of the renters failed April 1st across the nation. So what we have to do, what should be done, let me put it that way, is just like they did during the Depression, 27 states stopped all foreclosures. Okay, we need to stop foreclosures because the tenants can't pay and the landlords can't pay the banks. And somebody's got to take a haircut, okay? And it should be the stockholders and not the workers. So, good enough answer?
Yes, thank you, yes. Are you satisfied with the current structure of Portland city government? And if not, how would you change it?
Well, that's one of the questions that we have. Actually, it's a twofold question. Number one, should the city and county be merged? I think the informal agreement that there is between the city and council leaves a little slack. So if you merge the city and council, but this is my, our issue we're putting out there, okay? We wanna know what the people want. And the other one is, are we going to switch to a manager form of government with regional representation? I would assume, although we haven't had much time to get feedback in this corona situation, that there'd be a lot of support for that. So if there is a lot of support, yeah, I'll move forward with both of them.
Great, thank you. How would you address the public's significant concerns about police-community relations, use of deadly force, and officer accountability?
Well, certainly a major part of that is the contract. Okay, and I have not gone through the contract. I have some legal capabilities, having taken 9 cases to the state Supreme Court in Alaska. So I've got some, you know, and I would have to delve into that. But you have contract negotiations, and, you know, let me say this about that. Okay, this coronavirus has dropped crime 41%. Isn't that fascinating? That brought that result about. But I don't know, to answer your question, but it certainly is a problem of accountability between the people and the department.
Thank you. Last question. The city's park system faces serious financial challenges, even more so since the closures caused by the pandemic. What ideas do you have for securing the financial stability of our well-loved park system?
Okay, well, let me preface it with this, okay, is that from my perspective, what I think really isn't important, okay? I might have ideas, you know, and others have ideas, but I'm a gleaner, okay? I take ideas from people, and I want to see ideas and get support. You know, we did a free bicycle program in Anchorage for 15 years. You know, there are all kinds of things that people support. Now, something that I would be willing, one of our housing ideas is the creation of small villages, okay? And these small villages have to have a community agreement, okay? And specific to what you're addressing, if the public supports this, I would suggest putting those villages, some of those villages, in discrete park places where they can maintain the parks and take care of it with non-power tools, and make our parks beautiful without cost to the city. But that's just an idea. There's got to be a lot of support for it before it's going to happen.
Thank you. Thank you, Michael. This has been the Video Voter's Guide. Thank you for watching. The primary election is Tuesday, May 19th. Be sure to inform yourself about the candidates and ballot measures and exercise your right to vote.